book.
Jesus, Lord.
try 313.
I notice the print's smaller too.
The world is slipping on clean.
the verses and let everybody else to join in on the chorus. 3:12. The trio's here, we'll do the verses.
Thank you. I'd like to say we're certainly glad to have everyone here with us today, and at this time we'll be taking up the preacher's collection if everyone will stand. For the building fund today. Forgot what Sunday it was.
Since my horse is gone, let's go ahead and take one. 1:30. I'll never make it through.
Chris.
Thank you. Say we appreciate another day the Lord's given us, another opportunity to be back in his house. Thankful for all of you that are here this morning, and appreciate the day the Lord's blessed with. A beautiful day, the sun's shining. We've had some rain, and the Lord knows what we need when we what we stand in need of, and he always sends. Yeah, he's always on time, and I'm thankful for it. Sometimes we think that we don't need the rain, but we don't know what lies ahead. It may be a dry summer, so I'm not complaining. I guarantee you, I'm glad the Lord knows. And he'll take care of us. He promised he would. And so we're thankful to be here today. It's good to be back in the Lord's house and just to enjoy the blessings of the Lord and how good he is to us. Every day that he lets us wake up is another, to me, at my age, a bonus for me, and I'm thankful for it. I'm thankful for how far the Lord's let me get down the road and been able to enjoy all of his blessings and benefits down through the journey of my life. And if he never sent another one, I'd still have to say I'm blessed. But I know the Lord's good, and we get to wake up in the morning. He's got good things for us, and I'm thankful for it. And I appreciate all you this morning. I want you to pray for the service, pray for all the sick, the suffering around about the church, and not only here, but all the churches. I'm sure there's folks that need the touch of the Lord's hand, and he's able this morning. I'm glad that he can be in all places at all time. He's not limited as we are, but he's able to do and help all of us today, and he loves us today, and I'm glad that he does, and he proves it every day how much he cares for us. So let's pray for all of our sick around about the church. Continue to pray for Brother Bob. Lift him up. And Sister Gail and Joe. Pray for Sister Joe and Joe Jones and different ones. Sister Juanita and all. And Brother Warren. Let's remember him. And they've had to come this morning. Ambulance had to come get him and take him to the hospital. So let's just pray for him, that the Lord will be with him and help him. And there's others that need a touch this morning, and I know the Lord's able today to help all today. Remember our lost around about the church. Pray for them that they'd come to know the Lord as their Savior and find him to be precious unto them. Brother Ed, would you lead us in prayer this morning while we pray?
Father, to try to realize, Lord, I'm thankful this morning for the promises that you made to us, even though that our loved ones have to leave, Father, that, Lord, that we know you and they knew you, that we'll get to see them again. Another, that old song says, a glad reunion day, and we look forward to it, Lord, when we can lay aside, Father, all these things that trouble our hearts here in this life, and Father, we can be at home with you and with our loved ones. Lord, we look for that day and long for it. Father, we just ask you to help us, Lord, right now. Lord, how we need your help, Father, each one of us today. I know that we're not here by ourselves today, but all, Father, today that have gathered into your house, Lord, we need your leadership. We need your touch. I'm glad this morning, Lord, you're able to help us all. Father, bless all you men, Father, that stand in this hour, Father, to preach your word, Lord, that you'll undergird them with your strength and your spirit. God, help us today. Forgive us, Lord, of our many sins. Know we're available beings, Lord, and help us this morning. And, Father, we'll bow our unworthy heads, and we'll give you the praise, the honor, and glory for it all, for we ask it in the name of Jesus.
You pray for us for just a few minutes. Don't feel that we'd hold you very long, but we certainly want to mind the Lord and be obedient to that He'd have us to do today. Don't feel that we don't have very much on our heart, but yet we want to do all that we can. If the Lord would help us and come by and just strengthen us for a few minutes and give us utterance. We're still battling with pollen, and we can't ever get to the place to where our throat's really clear like we'd like for it to be, but I'm not making any excuses. The Lord's able to touch us this morning. He's able to help us, and with all of us this morning, I know this morning that we all have needs, and I'm glad that we know where our help comes from today, that He's a present help in the time of trouble, and I'm thankful this morning He'll help us with whatever need that we might have. If you have your Bibles, want to read with us this morning, we've got a verse or two in the book of Zechariah, the second chapter. We'll start about the fourth verse and read maybe a verse or two there, and then we'll look into the book of Acts, the second chapter, I believe it is, and we'll read a verse or two there. So you pray for us this morning. We need your help, and I know you can help us this morning. We need the Lord's touch, and we never got to that place to where we don't need His help. And I thought about trying to preach the Word of God. We can't do anything without the Lord, and we know we're helpless without Him. But I'm glad this morning, if we're willing to stand for Him, He's able to help us. So you pray for us this morning. We're just going to wait on the Lord. If you have us to say something from this, then we want to do it. The second chapter of the book of Zechariah, very familiar scripture, and we're thankful for the Word of God this morning. And we'll read, starting at the fourth verse of the second chapter, the Bible said, "And he said unto him, Run, speak to this young man, saying, Jerusalem shall be inhabited as a town without walls for the multitude of men and cattle therein. For I, saith the Lord, will be unto her a wall of fire round about, and will be the glory in the midst of her." So with that, this morning, reading a couple of verses this morning, and I thought about the fifth verse said, "The Lord said, I will be under her a wall of fire round about, and will be the glory in the midst of her." And I'm thankful this morning, and I know the scriptures here this morning, maybe talking about the natural Jerusalem, but I'd like to think this morning is talking about the church this morning, being those of His people that are, that inhabit the church this morning, that He'll be around us as a wall of fire and we'll be the glory in the midst of her. You're going to have to help us this morning. Our throats, like we've already said, the pollen and all that's going on there, we seem like this morning that we're kind of choked up, but this morning we're just going to make an effort, and you help us this morning as we look to the Lord for the need of the hour. And I'm thankful that the Lord, he said that he would be a wall of fire about her, and I'm glad this morning that the Lord, amen, he's always answered by fire, and he's still this morning to the church, you and I this morning, I'm glad that he's able to help us in our time of need. In the second chapter of the book of Acts, the Bible said in the first verse, and when the day of Pentecost was fully come, they were all with one accord in one place.
We're just going to wait on the Lord this morning, but I've got a little thought this morning and on our heart, and we certainly need your help today. Lord, we look to you in this hour that you help us this morning. You touch our throat and help us on that we might be able to stand one more time on this side of eternity, Lord, and give you praise. And Lord, and just Father, stand in the gap and make up the hedge on behalf of these this morning that are lost, that don't know you. And I know there's multitudes and multitudes this morning in the valley of decision that, Father, have come to that crossroads in their lives where they need, Father, your help. They need your guidance, and Lord, that they might choose you this morning that they might live. And I'm thankful this morning. I wonder this morning the thought that's on our heart today. If the Lord would help us today, where is the fire? This morning I know on the day of Pentecost the Bible said that Christ had spoke to them before he left. That he said, go you into Jerusalem and tarry there till you be endued with power from on high. And I'm glad as we've read in your hearings this morning that the Lord sent the fire. Thank God the Bible said there was a sound that came into the upper room as they were gathered there in one mind. In one accord, thank God they had. They've been there. They followed the Lord. The Lord has told them for to go over there and just wait. Thank God this morning. And that's what we're going to do. We're just going to wait upon the Lord. We're going to look to him this morning that he'll send the fire down. Thank God this morning. That's what all I need. That's what we need. It's his children this morning. We need the fire of God. This morning I'm glad that he's able to quicken this old outward man to give us utterance in the day that we live in. I want to stand one more time this morning and just preach unto you the word of God, that we might be able to be free one more time in the day that we live in. I know that we live to a day that long time don't say will say. The day of revival, the day of grace. Not many being saved this morning, but I'm glad this Bible said that the old Satan was a liar and he was the father of it. That's all that he's ever used is a lie. But I'm glad that we know that God is true, that he's still able this morning to send the fire. And I wonder a lot of times if we don't just get in a room a lot of times and thinking we'll sing this song and that song. And I appreciate the singing this morning. I'm running Joel, I appreciate you getting the old hymn book out again. That brings back a lot of memories. Amen. And where we pastored in the revival time that we've heard all these songs sung. And amen, it stirs our heart this morning. And I feel this morning that's what we need in our churches today. I'm not only here at Mount Moriah, but all of our churches. That we forget about. Amen. Thank God it gets pain. I made it laid out how we're going to do and what we're going to say. Amen. And just wait upon the Lord. Amen. I'm glad the Bible said they that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. They'll mount up with wings as eagle. Amen. They'll run and not be weary. They'll walk and not faint. This morning I'm glad. Amen. There's still can be some fire this morning that comes down in the day that we live in. And you pray for me. I don't mean to be amen so gross with this morning with our coffin, but I'm trying to get and I believe we can this morning. I'm just depending upon the Lord that he's going to send one more time to live today. And I know that we're not alone this morning. There's a lot, Brother Blake, there's a lot of the men this morning that's been probably trying to stand this morning. They're going to have to amen, make the cross and get beyond this old fleshly man. Amen. And the Bible said to be absent from the body is to be present with the Lord. And that's where I want to get. That's where we're trying to get to this morning. But I thought about these men. Thank God they were faithful. They went over there. They done what they could. Amen. And I believe when we've done all that we can do, I believe the Lord will take over. Thank God this morning. I thought about, thank God, old Elijah there. When he told the prophets of Baal, amen, he said, let us, amen, just try the God that we're, amen, that we're serving, that we've got confidence. I know we're paraphrasing, amen, but he said over there on the Mount of Carmel, amen, he said, you, I choose you out of sacrifice, thank God. Brother Rick, I tell you, there's a lot of things we can choose today. But I'll tell you, not everything that we choose is going to work. Amen, this morning, but I'm glad he said, you've been 450, I promise of hell, you go first. And then I'll come after you. But he said, choose you a sacrifice. Amen, and go ahead and prepare it. Amen, you go ahead and get it cut up and you lay it upon the altar. Thank God they're on the altar and put no wood on it. And he said to them, God that answered my fire, let him be. God, thank God this morning, the name of the Bible said that the prophets of the Baal, and the people there where they were pleased with that saying. Amen. And they went ahead and made ready. And they began to call upon their God. Amen. They started early. Amen. They began to cry out, but no answer. Amen. And the Bible said when it came down about the evening sacrifice that they cut themselves and they leaped upon the altar and there was no answer. Amen. But I'm glad, brother. And then Elijah, when they got through, the Bible said and then he repaired the altar and then it had been broken down. I believe this morning if we're going to have any fire as a Christian, we're going to have to repair some altar. Amen. And when we get them built, amen, repaired, we're going to have to use them. Amen. I found out that this is coming, and I'm just waiting on him. He'll see it walk with anything, God, this morning. But oh, Elijah prepared the altar, thank God. Amen. And he took him 12 stones. For one for every tribe, thank God he set it up. Amen. The way the Lord wanted it. Amen. It's not what I want, thank God. Amen. But I found that we're going to have power with him. And we're going to have to go the way the Lord said. Amen. And he got everything ready. Amen. Thank God he got the sacrifice. Amen. Amen. And he, amen. He got it on the altar there. Thank God. Amen. Thank God. I'm glad he, amen. He said, bring me some water. Amen. It dug a ditch around it, a trench around the altar there. And he began to pour the water on there. And he said, bring another barrel. Amen. Poured it on. He said, bring another. Amen. And again, another. Thank God. And it was well sodden. Amen. The Bible said the water flowed. Amen. Over the sacrifice, the altar, and even filled up the trenches. Thank God. The Bible said, let me tell you what old Elijah did to get the fire there. Thank God. The Bible said he got down. Amen. He began to pray and call upon his God. And I'm telling you, if we're going to get any fire, amen, in our churches, in our services, amen, it's going to come through prayer and supplication. Amen. Thank God this morning, he began to pray. Amen. And he called upon the God of Abraham. Amen. Isaac and Jacob. And he said, Lord, hear my prayer. And because he said, I've done all that you told me. Amen. Got everything ready. Amen. I'm glad this morning we got fixed up. This morning we, amen, got a shower. We got cleaned up. We got dressed. Amen. We made our way to the house of God. Made the preparation to come. Amen. Tried to pray before we left. I prayed last night before we went to bed. During the night, prayed. And the Lord told me, said, where's the fire? Amen. And I said, Lord, you have to send it. I don't have it, but thank God I'm just going to wait on you. Amen. You're going to send what we need. Amen. You know, Elijah, he just waited on the Lord. He said, Lord, I've done all according to your word, what you told me to do. How to get everything ready. Amen. And we're here. Let me tell you this morning, we've come in. Amen. We've made the effort. Amen. Let's just wait on the Lord to send what we need. Amen. And if we've asked, amen, I believe you'll send it. Amen. That we can say in a little while, amen, that we've been, amen, to meet him one more time. It's good to come to church. Amen. But when I get here, I like to go to meet him. Amen. I've made ready and done what I could. Amen. We're just waiting on the Lord. Amen. Oh, Elijah prayed. And the Bible said the fire, amen, it failed. Thank God. Amen. I don't believe it sprung up under the pot. Amen. Under the sacrifice. I believe it fell from heaven. Brother Ricky, if we're going to get anything, it's going to have to come down from above. Ain't nothing we can do, and nothing we can think. Amen, we may try. Amen, I tell you, I know a lot of places, and a lot of times, and I'm not being critical this morning, but all I'm hearing is a racket. Amen, but every once in a while, amen, people get their hearts right, they get to praying. They get to want to get to me. When they get to the church, they want to go to meeting. Amen. They've already prayed and expected it. When they get there, thank God. When we
we get to that place, the Lord will send the fire. Amen. He'll thank for this morning. Amen. The fire fell, brother, and it consumed the sacrifice. Amen. It consumed the altar. Amen. Even those rocks. Amen. That he put there, thank God, how to build the altar. Amen. It consumed them. It licked up the water. Now that was in the trenches. Amen. Let me tell you this morning. When you get to go to me, amen, ain't nobody gonna have to tell you that if we've been to meeting this morning, hey, there'll be some evidence of it. Thank God he'll come in. Amen, he won't be here. Amen, he'll get down in the heart, thank God. He'll begin to stir in there, thank God. Hey, old Ezekiel said it was a will within a will. Amen, when he gets to turning, brother, then you can go, thank God, this morning. Amen. You can feel, thank God, what the Lord has. Amen. You prayed for your loved ones. Amen. You may have come in burdened this morning about a situation. Amen. All I know to tell you this morning, just bring it to the Lord. Lay it on the altar this morning. Ask him to take care of it. Amen. Thank God in you. I'll tell you what, this morning you'll have some peace about it. Amen. Because you put it where you can get some help today. There's help in the Lord today. Thank God. Oh, Elijah, he's out there by himself. Thank God. The prophets of Baal, 450 people. About 450 of them. Amen. They was worshiping Baal. The children of Israel was worshiping Baal. Elijah said, how lost you between two opinions? If God be God, let's serve him. If Baal, let's serve him. Amen. Let's just try and see who's the real God today. Amen. And I'm glad he said the one that answers by fire, let him be God. Thank God. It failed, brother. I'm glad on the day of Pentecost there wasn't no doubt. Thank God when, amen, the Holy Ghost, when it failed, as it came in as a mighty rushing wind. Thank God, and it set upon those men, amen, clothed in tongues of fire. Thank God. What did it do? It gave them utterance. Thank God. They began to preach, amen, the word of God to these. They were all Galileans. And they said, how hear we? Amen. The word of God in our own language. Amen. Let me tell you, a man's been trying to figure out ever since that day how that happened. But let me tell you what happened, brother. Amen. The fire fell. Amen. The promise of the fathers. Amen. He promised them. Amen. That Joel said in the last day, amen, that the Lord would pour his spirit upon all flesh. Thank God. Upon, amen, his servants and his handmaids. Thank God. Amen, you young men. Amen, they'll see bed, dream dreams, and the old men will have vision. Thank God, I'll tell you. Amen, I've got to be an old man. Amen, amen, I'm glad I've got a vision this morning. Amen. Thank God the church rising up. Amen. Thank God having some fire about them. Amen. That the lost, when they get in the midst, amen, they're not going to be able to see it. The scripture said, and they not be able to see it among the righteous. Amen. Thank God there ain't no righteousness about what you're looking at this morning. But I tell you, amen, that I serve this morning, he's righteous. Amen. Thank God that I'm glad that the inside where he set up his abode. Amen. Thank God it's righteous this morning. And when I left this outward man, amen, could get in subjection to the inward man. Amen. And that man that's on the inside, thank God, takes superior, amen, superiority over this outward man, thank God, amen, that we're serving him, that we can't see with his natural eyes, thank God, the fire, amen, it'll be in our speech, it'll be in our singing, it'll be in our testimonies, thank God, amen, I tell you, I like it when we get a dose of the King Hippies, thank God, amen, you want to, amen, hit the floor and testify, amen, when that old natural man said, why, everybody think you said it, now they've heard that before, but you'll just let that inward man rule, thank God. First thing you know, Brother Joel, hey man, you're on your feet testifying. Thank God these preachers get the King Heaven about preaching. Thank God I wasn't intending on getting up, but first thing you know, you're already on the floor. Thank God, hey man, telling the wonderful things of the Lord this morning. I'm thankful, hey man, I still believe, hey man, on the fire falling. Thank God, and I wonder where it is, hey man, in our day today. Amen. I believe God's still sending it. I just wonder if we're responding to it when he, amen, when he nudges us, when he speaks to our heart. Amen. I tell you, when the Lord gives you a song, thank God. Amen. Just get up and say, I've got one. I need to lead this. Amen. Thank God. I'm sorry. I hope I'm not interrupting the service, but I've got to do that. That's all right. Thank God. The Lord said, I need to lead this song. The Lord said, I need to testify. Amen. The preacher, thank God. When the Lord gets, amen, stirring in his heart, he said, I know I don't have an appointment to preach here today, but I feel like I need to get up. Amen. Thank God this morning. I just use what you got, thank God, and what the Lord has. Amen. He sent the fire. Amen. We need to be. Amen. Thank God, quicken us. He said he quickened his old mortal bodies. Thank God. Amen. What's that? Made alive. Thank God. I mentioned about Brother Rick mentioned about Lazarus there after the Lord called to him, Lazarus, come forth. Thank God, and he came out. Amen. Amen. Thank God, out of that grave they put him in that old tomb. His bound hand and foot, brother, with a napkin over him. Amen. And how did he get out? Thank God, the power of God moved him. Amen. He was bound. Amen. He couldn't walk. Amen. But I don't know. I see him. Thank God, when he come out, he might have been about that high off the ground. Amen. The power of God brought him out. Amen. And what did he tell those onlookers? He said, just loose him and let him go. Thank God, I'm glad this morning. There's something for you and I as a church. Amen. There's some things that we need to lose. Amen. Old Satan may have you bound. Amen. This morning. Amen. Down with doubt and fear. Amen. I'm telling you this morning, the Lord wants you loose. Amen. Let me tell you this morning, as a pastor this morning, amen, I'm praying the Lord will set you free. I didn't come to point no fingers at anybody this morning. Amen. I got the message before you did. Amen. This morning, and the Lord was asking you. I mean, he said, Jerry, where's the fire you used to have? Amen. Where's the zeal I used to have to preach the word of God? And I said, Lord, I'm sorry. Amen. It's my fault. It's not yours. Amen. Old Satan said, you got too old to go and you got too old to preach. Amen. And I'll just tell him he's a liar. Amen. That I'm not serving a dead God this morning. Amen. He's still. Amen. If the Lord has sent it, I want to preach it. Amen. I want to tell you this morning that I've sinned and come short of the glory of God. I have to repent every day. Amen. That I might keep the fire. Amen. Going. Sometimes it gets down into the flicker. But there's still a fire. Thank God this morning. Amen. Amen. Thank God this morning. Amen. Amen. Where's the fire this morning? Where's it at in your life this morning? Where's that testimony you used to give? Where's that desire you used to have? Amen. To have to go, to get to go to the house of God, or is it? Oh, it's Sunday again. We have to go to the meeting today. We have to go to church. I've got, amen. There's so many things I wanted to do today. I'm going to have to let those things go just to go to church to please somebody else if they don't think anything bad about me if I don't show up. Amen. We need to get beyond that. It ought to be in our hearts and our lives. Amen. When it comes church time, we're amen. I'm so excited about going to see what's going to happen today. Amen. I'm going to go lift my hand. Thank God I'm going to get to sing in the choir. I'm going to lift my hand and let the Lord. I know there's some life in me. Thank God this morning. Amen. If he'll let me, I want to testify and tell everybody about how good the Lord is to me. Where's the fire this morning? Amen. Where's it at? Thank God. Amen. I need it. I've got to have it. Thank God. I can't do nothing without the fire this morning. Them old boys, amen, they were waiting. Amen. Thank God they couldn't do nothing. Amen. Until the Holy Ghost fell and gave them utterance. Amen. They're just as lifeless as they could be. Amen. Thank God. But I tell you, amen. Thank God. Oh, Ezekiel, he said, son of man, I can't even bones live again. Amen. He said, Lord, thou knowest. Amen. He said, you prophesy. Thank God unto these bones. Amen. What did he do? He got to preaching the word of God. Thank God that there got to be a moving and a shaking. Thank God. Bone came to bone. Amen. The sinew came upon them. Amen. And then the skin. Thank God that they, amen, were still lifeless. And he said, so I prophesied unto the poor wind. Amen. The wind began to move. Thank God that just like it did on the day of Pentecost. Amen. It come in as a mighty rushing wind. Amen. It filled them. Thank God. When they got filled, thank God they wanted to get up. Amen. Preach, thank God. They wanted to move. There was some life in them. Thank God this morning. Amen. Who said the wind? Amen. Came upon these. Thank God. Amen. Those that were in the valley. Amen. They were just dead bones. Amen. But I tell you, the word of God set things in order. I'll tell you, it will. Amen. He'll get things back in his place. Amen. If we'll hear it, amen. Thank God if we'll let the Spirit, amen, have free course in our hearts and our lives. Amen. We can see some things happen around the house of God. We can see the fire working. Thank God this morning. Amen. Amen. Thank God they stood up. Amen. The mighty army of the whole house of Israel. Thank God. Amen. They got to a place. They said, we're cut off from our part. Ain't no hope. Ain't no life. A lot of people, I'm talking about people, believers today, are in that shape. Amen. They can't even muster up enough faith to believe the Lord's still able to bless them. Thank God today. Amen. You just come. Thank God. Repent. Get your heart right. See if God won't fill you up this morning. Amen. I'll tell you, have a testimony of his saving grace. Amen. Want to tell everybody about the goodness of the Lord. Amen. Thank God. I tell you, it's all right. Amen. Amen. If you want to meet up over at Walmart and some of the aisles, thank God. Amen. We was there other day and we were blocking the aisle. Amen. But we'd meet up with some folks and want to talk about the goodness of the Lord. Thank God. I'll tell you this morning, that's all right. Thank God. Amen. I'd rather be talking about the goodness of the Lord than what all the wrong stuff that's going on in this world today. that amen has got people discouraged and tore up. Thank God. Amen. I tell you, if we get our minds back on the Lord, thank God, and let Him live in us. Thank God, and us live for Him. Thank God. Amen. We can talk about His goodness no matter where we're at. Have something good to think about. Thank God to talk about. Thank God. Bible said out of the abundance of the heart, the mouth speaking. Amen. Whatever you got down in there is going to come out. And if it's things of the world and trouble and worry, that's what's going to come out when you get to, when you open your mouth. But I tell you, if you got the goodness of the Lord down there, amen, that I might hide thy word in my heart, thank God. I hide him down in here, his word, thank God, that when you meet up with folks, you want to tell them about the goodness of the Lord. Thank God. And I'm glad this morning. The fire. Where is it this morning? Amen. I'm telling you, the Lord still sending it. We want it this morning. The Bible said He'd give us the desires of our heart this morning. Man, I'm praying all the way up the road, brother, that the Lord would meet here this morning. Thank God. I wanted to go meet Him when I got here. Thank God. I wanted to feel Him. I'm glad I got to feel Him during the Sunday school. Thank God. The song service was a blessing. Thank God. These songs that we hadn't sung in a while. Thank God. They're a blessing to us. Why? Amen. They were written. Thank God for people that I knew the Lord. Thank God. I believe the Lord impressed. Ain't a lot of them today being written. And all the reason they're writing them is, amen, they're going to make a dollar for them. But thank God, I tell you, these that are written, amen, people that went through some hard times and called upon the Lord, depended upon Him, He came to their rescue. Amen. And they began to pencil down. Thank God, their hearts were filled. Amen. They just began to pencil down what the Lord had done, how He worked in their life. And I'm thankful for that this morning. Amen. But let's keep the fire going. Thank God. Amen. I tell you, if we'll keep the fire going, brother, we can have some. We won't need no cold services. There'll be more. There'll be good spirits. But amen. If we'll keep the fire going around the house of God, thank God. And I tell you, it first, the Bible said charity begins at home. Thank God. I tell you, we're going to get in. And I believe charity is love. If we get any love, thank God, in our hearts, thank God. And when we come to the house of God, you know what we'll be sharing is love, thank God, and charity. Just bring it on with you. God, you may be the one that makes the difference in the service. Thank God. Your testimony, your song, your desire. Please, Lord, worship Him. My pleasure. I'm coming up on call.